This is how a pre-coated EB948 disc is delivered to us, immersed in a pluronic acid solution. Use a sterile tweezer to transfer the disc to a 6-centimeter dish. Make sure to place it with the wells facing up. Then wash it with DMEM F12 three times before use. As you can see, there are bubbles in the dish. It's important to get rid of these bubbles to prevent discs from floating, which prevents them from fully immersing in the media. We can do that by using two 10 microliter tips, one to push the dish down and resting the other on the side of the dish to facilitate escape of the bubbles. You can lift the disc a little bit, and that's it. The disc is now ready to be used immediately. We start with two 10-centimeter dishes of human iPSCs at 80% confluency. There should not be any spontaneously differentiated cells in the culture. In case there are some differentiated regions, follow the steps of our removing spontaneous differentiation video to remove them before proceeding to the next step. Wash the cells with 5 milliliters of DMEM F12. Remove the media by aspiration and add 5 milliliters of Accutase to each dish to dissociate the cells. Incubate the cells at 37 degrees Celsius for 3 to 5 minutes. Once the colonies have detached, which can be facilitated by tapping the sides of the dishes, add 5 milliliters of DMEM F12 to stop the enzymatic reaction. Transfer all the volume of the cell suspension from both dishes into a 50 milliliter tube. In order to collect as many cells as possible, wash the dish with an extra 5 milliliters of DMEM F12 and then transfer all the volume to the same 50 milliliter tube. It is important, however, to minimize pipetting of the cells at this step to preserve their viability. Centrifuge this 50 milliliter tube for 3 minutes at 1200 RPM. While the tube is in the centrifuge, prepare for cell counting by aliquoting tripin blue in a sterile 0.2 milliliter Eppendorf tube. After centrifuging, a cell pellet will be formed at the bottom of the tube. Next, remove the supernatant without disturbing the pellet. To count the number of cells, you will need to create a single cell suspension first, taking into consideration the desired number of cells. For the generation of midbrain organoids, we seed 10,000 cells per well, which is 9.5 million live cells for 948 wells in the EB disc 948. To create a single cell suspension, add 1 milliliter of neuronal induction media with ROCK inhibitor and resuspend the pellet up and down, first by using a 5 milliliter serological pipette, then a 1 milliliter tip to continue the process, and finally, a 200 microliter tip placed on top of a 1 milliliter tip. It is crucial to seed single cells at this step to get uniform EBs later on. You should take as much time as needed to carefully make a single cell suspension. Next, count the cells and evaluate the cell viability with tripin blue that you previously aliquoted. An appropriate viability percentage is around 95% of live cells in the cell suspension. Once you have estimated the cell count, prepare a mix of 9.5 million live cells in 1.5 milliliters of neuronal induction media with ROCK inhibitor. Please note that, instead of making a cell suspension in the total volume of the dish, we concentrate the cells by resuspending it in the lesser volume and seeding that first. This prevents cells from flowing underneath the disc, thus resulting in the desired number of cells per well. Aspirate DMEM F12 from the dish containing the disc. Slowly, add 1.5 milliliters of cell suspension in the center of the EB disc 948, where the platform is located. Next, centrifuge the disc at 1200 RPM for 10 minutes. This allows the cells to aggregate and settle at the bottom of the microwells. After centrifugation, we add 6 milliliters of neuronal induction media with ROCK inhibitor to complete the volume. The extra media should be added slowly on the side of the dish to avoid disturbing the aggregates formed in the microwells. The media should fill the dish and properly cover the surface of the EB disc. Don't forget to remove the bubbles. Before changing the media, verify the EBs under the microscope. This is how they should look like at day 2. To change the media at subsequent stages, remove the media slowly from the side to avoid disturbing the EBs. You can do that by making some space between the disc and the dish using a pipette tip and placing the aspirator tip adjacent to it. We will be using media previously warmed up at room temperature. On day 2, the media is changed from neuronal induction media without ROCK. On day 4, we use midbrain patterning media. Using a 5 milliliter sterile serological pipette, homogenize the media by pipetting up and down. Now, add the media slowly on the corner of the dish. Please note that pouring the liquid on top of the disc will cause EBs to lift. Next, eliminate the bubbles. The dish is now ready to be stored in the 5% CO2 37 degrees Celsius incubator. When looking at the EBs under the microscope on day 7, you will most likely notice the appearance of neuroectodermal buds, as indicated by the black arrowheads. These buds become more pronounced after 24 hours in Matrigel embedding. Note that to embed EBs in Matrigel growth factor reduced, we use cold serological pipettes or pipette tips. Start the procedure by aspirating the media. Then, take 1.5 milliliters of non-diluted Matrigel growth factor reduced and slowly add it to the center of the disc, to the platform. This way, Matrigel will evenly spread across all wells. Place the dish back into the incubator for 30 minutes. Now, complete the volume with 7 milliliters of tissue induction media after the incubation time is complete. Eliminate any existing bubbles. When checking under the microscope on day 8, you should notice that the buds become more pronounced, as mentioned before. The most fun part of using the disc is transferring the organoids to a culture vessel which, for this application, is a bioreactor. For this, we will need sterile metal forceps, bioreactors, previously assembled and autoclaved, and a 10-centimeter dish. With sterile metal forceps, carefully transfer the EB disc to a 10-centimeter dish containing 15 milliliters of the final differentiation medium. Place the disc with the microwells facing downwards. Then, gently agitate the disc with the metal forceps. Most of the embedded organoids should float out into the medium, as you can see here. Using a 50 milliliter pipette with a broad diameter, transfer the organoids in suspension to an autoclaved 500 milliliter spinning bioreactor containing 300 milliliters of final differentiation media. Repeat this step until there are virtually no more organoids in the disc or floating in the media. Place the bioreactor on a magnetic stirrer set at 42 RPM inside a 5% CO2 37 degrees Celsius incubator. Make sure to loosen the lateral caps of the bioreactor to ensure proper air-gas exchange. At this stage, the midbrain organoids can be observed floating in the final differentiation media. The organoids can be kept in culture for long term, up to a year. A weekly media change is required for maintenance of these organoids. Note that the volume of final differentiation media should be increased up to 500 milliliters in bioreactors, as midbrain organoids become bigger and media starts turning yellow by the time of the next media change. After every media change, make sure the bioreactors are properly replaced on the cross marks of the magnetic stirrer to ensure the proper spinning motion within the flask. A disturbance in the flow of the media will lead to the disintegration of the organoids. Cultures should be accessed regularly for growth and potential microbial contamination. Additionally, perform a mycoplasma test every month to ensure the quality of the material prior to using it for your experiments.